You mentioned Nikki Haley, and I know, Lindsay, you had a wide-ranging interview recently with her.
Sure did. We talk about Trump, the war in Gaza, abortion, and what she calls the women's issue of our time, which she says is not abortion, but trans kids in sports.
Former South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley's presidential campaign is racking up major donor and establishment support, now becoming a major threat to rivals who want to be an alternative to Donald Trump. And with just weeks to go before the Iowa caucuses, Haley is hoping voters will see her as a viable alternative.
I want to start where the last debate left off, where one question went unanswered as far as, is Donald Trump fit to be president? Do you think Donald Trump today in 2023 is fit to be president?
It's not about fitness. I think he's fit to be president. It's should he be president. I don't think he should be president.
The former United Nations ambassador also weighing in on the pressing war in Gaza.
Who do you think should control Gaza?
I think Israel does not want Gaza, but they don't want terrorists living in Gaza. You can't go through something like October 7th and chance that happening to your people again, because Hamas has already said that they're going back, they're going to do it again.
And for one of the most important issues on voters' minds, I asked Haley about the case involving a 31-year-old Texas mother who asked the court to allow her to get an abortion in order to save her uterus and preserve her chance to have healthy children in the future.
I don't know the details of the case that you're referring to. What I can tell you is I don't think that this issue needed to be in the hands of unelected justices. It needs to be in the hands of the people, because it's a personal issue for every woman and man. And so while I'm unapologetically pro-life, I have always said I don't judge anyone for being pro-choice any more than I want them to judge me for being pro-life. So we're watching states make these decisions. I think the goal should always be, how do we save as many babies as we can and support as many moms as we can? And that's not going to happen unless we find consensus. Let's make sure doctors and nurses who don't believe in abortion shouldn't have to perform them. Let's make contraception accessible. And let's make sure no state law says to a mom who has an abortion that she's going to jail or getting the death penalty. Let's start there. And let's start humanizing this issue instead of demonizing this issue.
She is also very clear that biological boys, she says, should not be playing in girls' sports. That's something that she talks about quite in length. We also get a chance to talk to her daughter, Rena, who really gives us a sense of Nikki Haley as the mom. And we also get her reaction to being name-checked on the debate stage by Vivek Ramaswamy about having a TikTok account.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
You did not hold back at all. Neither did she. And you can watch Lindsay's full interview on ABC News Live Prime tonight, starting at 7 p.m. Eastern. Going to be a long day for you, Lindsay.
Yes.
Thank you. Okay.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.